was so stupid of me. I bought that talk of friendship. The stupid musketeer saying, just you wait, I will get even. I wonder though, why did Pavel go through the trouble of trapping me?
Move it! Hey, stop that, bleh! It's just being over-enthusiastic, you know? Artyom, look, I think of you as my friend, really. But as a soldier, you understand that I had to follow my orders and bring you here, okay? Now, you're under arrest, but perhaps it's not the end of the line for you. I hope.
Good day, sir. Good day, sir.
At ease, товарищ. So, you're doing good here? Are you not?
Yes, sir. Comrade Moskvin is here, inspecting the troops.
The Secretary General?
Yep.
What about Comrade Korn?
Yes, sir. Comrade General is here too.
Opa, it's my lucky day, huh? Okay, things are moving faster than we anticipated.
Do it!
Artyom, you're a smart guy, so we understand there is no such thing as coincidence. You are here because we need you. You have information. So, my advice to you, my friend, cooperate. Okay? But don't worry, I got your back. Because we are what? Musketeers! All for one, and one for all. But your comrades in the order, their motto is all for us. War is coming, my friend. That bunker you guys found, whoever controls it survives and fuck the rest of us. But we have been preparing for this. And I want you to join us, Artyom. Good day, Comrade General!
Comrade Morozov, I was beginning to think you had not survived your mission.
I was captured, Comrade Korbut. This ranger here, saved me.
What a coincidence. Visnitsky, you're one of the Spartan rangers. Do you know this man?
Yes, sir. His name is Artyom. Miller trusts him. They found D6 together. He's also earned several commendations since official enlisting with the Order.
Well, I am overjoyed to meet you, Comrade Artyom. I think we both have something to offer. Take the comrade to the negotiation room.
Young man, let's dispense with the introductory probing and cut to the chase.
This telepathic mutant, the so-called Dark One, is of extreme scientific significance. Tell me all you know about it, and I will allow you to keep your life and your job with the Rangers. But as my spy and operative, just like those musketeers, one for all and all for...
Secretary General Comrade Moskvin.
Korbut, I need a moment. And what do we have here? Another enemy of the revolution? Perfect. As you have always noted, Leonia must start learning how to improve his people skills.
As a matter of fact, we were...
Yeah, put away your truth serums. I'll show you a more traditional Red Army method. Faster and more effective. You shit! Spill your guts now! Tell everything you know of D6! Fuck! Still nothing, huh? Take that, bitch! You talk, or I'll fry your balls in pig fat! Passwords? Code names? Operation protocols?
What are you doing, Dad?
This is called interrogation, Lonia. Interrogation. Business as usual. What? You never did that playing dolls?
No!
You little shit! There's no power without blood!
There is! Your brother ruled peacefully, and they still love him!
Get back here!
You're a thug!
God damn it!
Butcher.
All right. Use your drugs. Use hot pokers. Just get everything out of him and shoot the bastard! And then come to my office. We must talk.
Come back here! You may be my
friend. Oh, I must agree with Leonid. Brutality is a crooked path to information. I believe in science. One injection and you will tell us everything. And take care of the locals who made the delivery. This will not be a cash payment. Understand?
Completely, sir. And what about the Dark One?
The creature has been located. The details are in this envelope. You will pick up the animal right after you go to Venice. Don't disappoint me this time.
I won't, Comrade General. I won't.
Revolution and my own future. I'd rather be shot and end up like father, killing his own brother. Listen, if you get out of here, just live. Here, get in there. This is the way to freedom. Believe me, I know. I spent all my childhood hiding from my father in those vents.
Negotiations in police?
Ah, so you already know.
I am the head of intelligence, after all.
Then why did you let the information leak? Damned refugees. Polis, Hansa, and even the fucking Nazis already know about our plans.
The rats will be exterminated. And war is inevitable anyway.
Inevitable? I have my doubts. So does the Politburo.
A doubtful man is a fearful man.
How dare you? You're the head of state security and you report to me!
Yes, but now, when we are one step away from a unified Red Metro, you have no right to disrupt the plan.
I have no right? I'm...
Moskovin, when you asked me how to deal with your elder brother when he was still the Secretary General, I helped you. And after his tragic death, I backed your takeover. So I suggest you take my advice again.
This is unacceptable.
It's very simple, Comrade Moskvin. We all stand together, arms linked against the wind. Or it's every man for himself.
But, Korbut, is this whole fucking metro truly worth the blood we're going to spill?
I have a way of doing it without spilling any blood.
No blood, you say? All right. Go do your trick. I'll handle the Politburo.
A frontal assault is hopeless. But if we go underground at the church, advance through the catacombs, then attack from the rear, we should encounter little or no resistance. Then we just have to do a sweep.
Attention! Comrade General!
Soldiers, you are trusted with an important mission.
Each group has its task, and you have been told only what you need to know to succeed. But remember that this operation is top secret, and you must not be taken alive by the enemy. I hope that I am understood. Questions?
Can we use radios after we capture the assigned duct?
Only in case of emergency, and on a scrambled frequency.
If we're faced with strong enemy counterattacks, do we hold the positions or fall back?
Hold them. Anyway, the enemy is unlikely to mount an effective counteroffensive.
Comrade General, we have been issued a banner along with the other gear, but we were also made to remove all our markings.
We will leave no trace of our operation. Only upon victory and receipt of the following signal will you raise your banner over the captured targets. Further questions?
No, Comrade General.
Good luck, then.
Serving the red line!
Now I am in the real spider-infested catacombs, where the General Secretary Moskvin does not look like the head spider. That title clearly belongs to General Korbut. I sure would like to know what's on his mind. What did Lesniski bring him from D6? What's going to destroy the enemies of the revolution? Only questions.
The manual says it's the red wire. The bolt's the one you cut.
You cut it yourself. I'll go stand there around the corner.
Piss your pants already? Then watch a real man.
Well, if you're a real man, why are your hands shaking?
Hands don't mean shit. The important thing is nothing else shakes. Okay. Composed. Composed.
Take.
Almost there.
Scared, huh?
Hey, get off my case. Let me think.
Well, I see this is taking forever. So I'll go.
What? Hey,
what the? Hello? Enemies right here!
Thank you.
doing here? Who's gonna patrol the premises? Me alone? Come on, get to work, all of you!
Yes, sir.
Ivan, stay! Did you take care of the rats? I want them all burnt!
Commander, we're not rats. Shooting is one thing, but we can't burn people alive.
What do you mean, people? Shooting? Are you out of it?
Aren't you talking about the refugees?
What refugees? Let the special department handle them. I'm talking real rats, tails and all. They've multiplied like crazy. So you go.
Huh? Seems like...
What the hell are you doing here? Who's gonna patrol the premises? Me alone? Come on, get to work, all of you.
Yes, sir.
Ivan, stay! You take care of the rats. I want them all burnt!
Commander, we're not Nazis. Shooting is one thing, but we can't burn people alive.
What do you mean, people? Shooting? Are you out of it?
Aren't you talking about the refugees?
What refugees? Let the special department handle them. I'm talking real rats, tails and all. They've multiplied like crazy. So you go and do it! On the double!
Yes, sir.
Yeah. fuel cover.
Very cool.
accept the delivery and sign the manifest?
I sure did.
Where'd you put the goods?
Wherever I had space left. Top shelves, mostly.
Can you be more specific?
Specific? Wherever I left the ladder. There's our goods. My ship's nearly over. Pass to the other guy when he arrives.
All right. I'll go and check if everything's still there.
Ah! going to stand here much longer?
We should be coming back from the war soon.
Did you ever do watch duty there?
Yeah, it's a creepy place. The station's nearby. Machine gun, searchlight, your comrades are around. There's something lassos in the cobwebs and the sound just freezes blood.
Why not burn those whips?
We do that all the time. In a couple of weeks, damn beast.
Down, or your brain goes splat.
Wait a minute.
Artyom, is it you?
I was able to send a report back to the Order via my old acquaintance, Andrew the blacksmith. At least Miller will know that I am alive, that I haven't completed the mission, but haven't resigned from it either.
That's one serious pickle you're in.
but I can help. I have friends, and they have friends who can relay everything you tell me to your guys from the Order. So, now you must return home, to Polis? Well, there's no direct route. Everything's cordoned off here. But I believe the Order has an outpost nearby. On the surface. The church in the marshes. Try that place. If we can get word to your people, they might meet you there. As for me, I started life anew. Left Kuznetsky Most. The Reds completely subverted the place. Looking for traitors and spies. Sending people to camps, or just shooting them. All because of the coming war. People are fleeing from Kuznetsky Most, and they're all red line. Come here, Artyom. Did you see the armored train the Reds are building? Well, we built something too, with the stuff the refugees are bringing. Here, take a look. At this baby, the boys even gave her a name. You can't help but fall in love with her. She did a swell job running refugees, but hell, you can't save everyone. So, take it. We have people in Venice, too. When you get there, find Woodpecker and tell him where you left our baby. Climb aboard. Come on, climb aboard. All right, start the engine. We're still tinkering with her, so the controls aren't perfect. But the lights are first class. No need to fear the spider bugs around her. And there's a lot of those in the far tunnels. You should go. It's a long way, so you shouldn't waste any time.
Thank you.
Pavel's group is advancing towards Tretikovskaya, also known as Venice. They have a few hours lead on me and are moving via frequently used tunnels, but I will catch up. I can't afford not to.
Name.
He doesn't look like a GB. I don't recognize the uniform.
Could he be one of ours? Look at all his weapons.
Don't shoot! We are civilians! There are women and children here! Leave and let leave, okay?
We're refugees from the Red Line. I'm in charge here, basically. No, there's nobody under my command. All the battle-worthy men went with the other caravan. Half a click ahead. I thought they'd protect us.
But they were attacked.
We heard the shooting. It subsided. But it doesn't look like our people survived. So we can't go any further. And if we go back, it's the firing spot for us. You look like you've seen your share of fights. Can you help us? It's not for me, but I pity the children.
So what do we do now? How do we live without them?
They might still be alive. Don't bury them yet.
But the shooting was so loud, and now there is nothing.
And what if they won?
Why? Why don't they come for us then?
They might come soon. Let's just wait.
Do you think they killed them all?
They could have. Or it could be worse.
How?
Women were with them. If ignorance is bliss, you're the happiest guy around.
So, are we going to help our guys or what?
What help can just the two of us be?
If they're pinned down, we could flood the bandits.
Let's get ready then.
Well, you're not going anywhere. Who's going to protect the women and children?
But we can't let the bandits butcher our guys.
That stranger is going to help us. Looks like he's worth 20 of you anyway.
You are an idiot to believe you're Andre the blacksmith. Oh, it's safe. You'll get there in no time. And you dragged me here. And now we're all gonna die because of your stupid blacksmith.
Shut your mouth. Andre's a saint. He got us all out. And lots of people before us.
Yeah, He got us out just to be robbed by bandits.
And how the hell was he supposed to know about the bandits?
Then he shouldn't tell people.
A classic.
Safe.
Almost indestructible. It's sure to outlive
us all. How about the GB? He did save us from them.
And what difference does it make if we're still going to be killed by bandits?
Dumb woman!
Thanks. Shoot a couple of bandits with this.
Look at you.
You tell me, Yasha. What made you flee?
Mobilization, of course.
A boy your age has no business with a rifle.
They always ordered me. But then, I was summoned to duty. Mom said with my luck, I'd bite the dust the second I hit the front lines. So, she got me into this caravan. Which seems like a mistake now.
You're still young. You'll find a place for yourself if we get anywhere. But me, I served them for 20 years. 20! They gave me a pension.
Come again.
100 grams of mushrooms and a bullet a day. And they don't let me beg, saying it's a disgrace to the motherland. So, I choose treason over hunger. So, who'd ever need me?
So I left, because the war is approaching, and our station's right in the way. During the last war, the people ran, but there was a rifle squad of our own soldiers at the rear.
This is
they
just
shot
a thing
everyone.
For bandits.
Women, children, old men.
Bye!
Did not let the panic spread. So I learned the lesson and ran before it started. And here we are. Stuck.
Yes, you guys at the edge stations have it tough. Not that we're better off. But because I got back, so I can go to
I'm like, we're free here, huh? There's not enough food here with that asshole. Who goes there?
Stand still or we shoot. We're armed.
We are armed. Swear by Lenin's name.
He doesn't look like a GB. I don't recognize the uniform.
Could he be one of ours? Look at all his weapons.
Don't shoot! We are civilians! There are women and children here! Leave and let leave, okay?
We're refugees from the Red Line. I'm in charge here, basically. Now there is nobody under my command. All the battle-worthy men went with the other caravan. Half a click ahead. I thought they'd protect us.
But they were attacked. We heard the shooting. It subsided. But it doesn't look like our people survived. So we can't go any further. And if we go back, it's the firing spot for us. You look like you've seen your share of fights. Can you help us? It's not for me, but I pity the children.
So what do we do now? How do we live without them?
They might still be alive. Don't bury them yet.
But the shooting was so loud. And now there's nothing.
And what if they won?
Why? Why don't they come for us then?
They might come soon. Let's just wait.
You think they killed them all?
They could have. Or it could be worse.
How?
Women were with them. Yasha, if ignorance is bliss, you're the happiest guy around.
So, are we going to help our guys or what?
What help can just the two of us be?
If they're pinned down, we could flank the bandits.
Let's get ready then.
You're not going anywhere. Who are you going to protect the women and children?
We can't let the bandits butcher our guys.
That stranger is going to help us. Looks like he's worth 20 of you anyway.
Take the horse and kill all the men.
So you heard my friend.
Ah, yes.
thought I was done for. They took everyone still alive. The kids, the women. I'll move the rail car so that you can drive through.
You follow them. Be careful of the technical tunnel. I heard the bandits talk about the trap there.
Thank you.
Let me know. Okay.
What here? the fuck is up with you?
To our jury. The boss said if we let just one fist stay by, he's gonna have our ass.
No shit. Let's go.
You're a bastard! No!
Okay, okay, you can tell me the tale later. Right now, we're entering the fairway and plotting a course to the base.
The snow on the surface starts melting. The familiar rail cars are now joined with boats and fishermen. One of them appeared just in the nick of time. Soon we'll be docked at Venice. Pavel is most probably already there.